He's from downtown Albany, New York, just a few blocks away from where Iron Mike Tyson made his pro debut. The local city-sponsored boxing club that has been on a roll producing solid fighters came up with Abraham Nova, who we saw a few weeks ago in this ring. And now Will himself, very confident that he can stay the course. This is a guy who has worked tirelessly at the Center for Disabilities in recent years, but has pushed in all the chips on his boxing career. And he's hoping that that bet pays off tonight. The Geico tail of the tape. As you will see, Verdejo is 2 inches taller, has the reach advantage, and CompuBox has the lightweight average at 18.6 for jab connect percentage. Verdejo's at over 27%. Madeira is just under 13%. Generation of Puerto Rican fighters look to Tito Trinidad, then they look to Miguel Cotto. There have been so many strong boxers from the island. It was supposed to be Felix Verdejo who was going to be the next big star. He has no issue acknowledging the trajectory going off course, saying it was all my fault. But now he feels like he's making the proper life choices, great career decisions, a new training home, a new trainer. He's always been explosive, dynamic when he's primed and ready, and that is the way he feels tonight. Ten-round lightweight main event, Madeira and Verdejo, and they get a set. Here's Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome inside the MGM Grand here in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. This is boxing presented by Bob Arum's Top Rank. This bout is scheduled for 10 rounds in the lightweight division. Our judges at ringside, Tim Cheatham, Max DeLuca, and Julie Letterman. The man in charge at the sound of the bell, Mr. Robert Hoyle. This is boxing. This is Top Rank. And this is the main event! Fighting out of the blue corner, presented in association with Dennis Benoit's Live Co Boxing. He weighed in at 135.8 pounds, wearing black trunks with red trim. He brings a record of 15 wins, no losses, 3 draws, 8 wins by way of knockout. From Albany, New York, Ill Will Madeira! Fighting out of the red corner. He weighed in at 135.9 pounds, wearing multicolored trunks. He brings a record of 26 wins, 1 defeat, 16 victories by way of knockout. A 2012 Olympian from San Juan, Puerto Rico, Felix El Diamante Verdejo!
Okay, gentlemen, I warned you in the dressing room about rabbit punches. Golpe de canejo. Don't do it, okay? As you can see right here, aquí malo, anything on here is a low blow, okay? Once you give me a good, clean fight and obey my commands. Touch them up.
We invite you to go to ESPN.HearMeCheer.com to participate live. It's a fanless atmosphere, of course, with the COVID restrictions, but that doesn't mean that your voice can't be heard. That's ESPN.HearMeCheer.com to hear your voice cheer along during this main event. Dre, a main event in which Will Madeira, the 15-0-3 fighter, is very confident, and he told us why last night when we visited with him. He actually was at Verdejo's last fight back on January 18th. It was in upstate New York. It was at the Turning Stone Resort, just about a 90-minute drive from his home, Madeira's home in Albany, New York. He said, I went to the fight, and I realized something. He said, Verdejo runs out of gas after about the 5th round. He said he slows down. I think I can make him fight early, take him to the deep waters. I was watching him get hit by shots that he shouldn't get hit by, and he feels like he can take him late.
Yeah, he sounds very confident. He said all the right things, and now he has 10 rounds or less to prove it. But I don't think it's going to be as easy as he thinks it's going to be. If you look at the pedigree with these two fighters, Madeira was a national-level fighter. That's as high as he got. Verdejo lost in the quarterfinals to Vasily Lomachenko at the 2012 Olympics. So the pedigree is a lot different. That doesn't guarantee victories for either guy, but just understand that Verdejo's coming in here with a different pedigree tonight.
I honestly think that Verdejo's coming here with just a different mentality, period. I mean, everything has always been lined up for him to shine. He just didn't probably realize it back then. Maybe it was just the pressure of things. It was too much pressure for him. But, you know, he just needed time to mature, I believe. And, you know, what he's projecting, you know, getting a sense from where I saw him yesterday and talked to him last night, you know, it just seems like he's matured and he's in the right headspace now.
Keep him up.
But Verdejo is a solid fighter. He's steady. He's got a good jab. And his best punch is the right hand. And he's already landed that shot a few times on the chin of Verdejo.
There's a left hook from Verdejo. And that long jab to the body.
Tess, Verdejo has the best jab at 135 pounds. Snapping, quick, hard jab.
There's a 1-2. The right hand was well placed.
Tess, no one in this division have a jab like Verdejo.
In all the 135 pounds, the world champions, the top contenders, this is the best jab at lightweight right here, Timmy.
The best jab. To me, he has the best. He has the hardest and stiffest jab. It's quick. Quick. Shotgun jab.
Comes underneath with a right hand to the body. And then gets him hurt.
He sends him back.
Madeira's hurt here in round one. Left hook comes in, sweeping right hand. Sends him back with a right hand that got to the top of the head. Uppercut, glancing blow, and down goes Madeira. What an unbelievable attack from Verdejo.
5, 6, 7.
That's it. Wow, how impressive was that? Come on. Absolute blasting. Felix Verdejo does damage. Hands Will Madeira the first loss of his career. A first round knockout statement made.
So I was trying to explain in the beginning, fellas. You know, there's truly levels and there's different levels of pedigree. Taking nothing from Madeira, solid fighter, but Verdejo came in here as the top dog for a reason. He's the A side for a reason. And a fighter always looks easy to you, sitting in the comfort of your seat or sitting in the comfort of your home when you're not in there with him. But when you get in there with him, you realize, oh, he's faster than I thought. You know what? He hit a lot harder than I realized, and he's better than what was publicized, and Madeira understands that right now.
Dre, Madeira was a good fighter, man. He was a good fighter. I'm letting you know that, man. I watched his tape. He can fight, and he can bring the pain. But, man, Verdejo is ready. This is the Verdejo of the old. Trust me. Snap and jab, great combinations, great counter punching. Wow. What an entertaining performance, my goodness. Look at that uppercut. Look at the uppercut he lands right there. Perfect range, perfect distance, set down on that uppercut, came right up the middle.
But that's the finish right there. That's not where the trouble started. The trouble started a few seconds earlier with the uppercut. Same combination, but it started earlier in the center of the ring. And Madeira never saw it coming. He drifted to the ropes, and Verdejo did the right thing. He didn't overshoot his target. He went right back to the same combination that caused the trouble in the first place. Powerful, powerful shots landed. And there you see Madeira on the ground trying to figure out what just happened.
He put the 135 pound on notice tonight with this performance. Trust me, everybody's gonna be talking about Felix Verdejo.
But Tim, let me just jump in real quick. When you're a fighter with the pedigree as Verdejo, he was supposed to do that, right? So Madeira's a solid fighter, but he was supposed to do that, and he has to continue to win like that to get himself in line for a title.
He's supposed to do that, Dre. I understand that. But you know where this young man came from. He was a 2013 Prospect of the Year, had a motorcycle accident, lost the fight, and rebounded his career. Now, this type of performance sending a message to me, to the whole division. Now,
everybody had questions.
Everybody had questions about his heart. Everybody had questions about his determination. Everybody had questions about his will to win. He showed us tonight that he's here and he's here to stay.
a really good
division. I guarantee you Ishmael Salas is telling him.
Just got deeper, Dre.
The coach is telling him, he comes from Cuba. That's the place where you're supposed to win. That's the mindset that he's given his pupil, Verdejo. He told Verdejo, you're not the best anymore. You have to show that you're serviceable. He's humbling the young kid, and I guarantee you, you see them celebrating right now? This is what they expected. They're going to go back to the drawing board and keep looking for that title shot. They're not happy right now. He was supposed to do that. Great performance.
Let's make it official with Mark Chinook.
Ladies and gentlemen, here inside the MGM Grand, referee Robert Hoyle calls a stop to this bout at 2 minutes and 59 seconds of round number one, declaring your winner by technical knockout, Felix El Diamante Verdejo!
27-1 now, with 7.